What's up, guys? HockeyDude1940 here, and this is episode 3 of the NHL 14 BGM mode for the Colorado Avalanche. And I made a mistake. I did the third episode a day or two ago, and it was actually a 20 plus minute episode. And for some reason, when I downloaded it from my camera to my computer, it downloaded it and saved it as a song file or something like that, like a media file, and that's not what it's supposed to do. It's supposed to save it as a video file. And so for some reason, when I tried to upload it on YouTube, there was some kind of error. It couldn't upload that type of content, so it ended up just getting deleted. And so yeah, but nothing much happened, even though it was 20 minutes. I pretty much just talked about stuff that was going on around the NHL. But anything I talked about, I've already talked about over again. But basically what we did in that video was we simulated up to the trade deadline. And the team, as you can see, isn't doing too well. Still 25, 26, and 11. So we made a big-time trade. Let's see, where can we see this? I think it's player picking and trading. Where is it? Yeah, right here. We traded Paul Stastny, Matt Hunwick, a second-round pick to the New Jersey Devils in exchange for Jaromir Jagr, Marek Sedlicki, and a first. So that was a great trade, because if you look at Jaromir Jagr, see his contracts. And you may have been able to tell on the side there, he is actually now leading our team in goals. Jaromir Jagr, he's 87 overall with my roster update. And he's got great offensive categories. And look at that, this season he's 50 points in 63 games with 27 goals. So I picked him up as that first line right wing, because we pretty much had to trade Paul Stastny, because he was going to be a free agent. We weren't going to be able to sign him. And Nathan McKinnon's already our, second-line center of the future. So I want to put him in the second-line center spot. So I did that. So now hopefully that kind of turns the team around. But yeah, that's pretty much all we did in that episode that was lost. So nothing too much. So now here we go. First period, this is the team. The first game with the new team. Duchesne scores there. And we won 1-0. Alright, that's good. Oh man, I don't know why the screen looks terrible right now. Sorry about that, guys. And my birthday is in August, so I hope to get two things. I hope to get an Elgato game capture. So I can, record the gameplay. And Blue Snowball microphone or Blue Yeti. I forget which one, but one of those two. I think it's the Yeti. That's the better one. I plan to get one of those microphones too, so, this type of video. So hopefully that'll be coming in August. But also, thank you guys for all the support in the comments. I've seen a few comments recently. Over the past few days, you guys have been saying, nice vid. Just that kind of stuff. It just motivates me to keep putting out content, and I just really appreciate it when you guys, say stuff like that. And, I've gotten a couple friend requests and messages on PSN, saying, oh, I saw your video, I subscribed to you. I just love seeing that kind of stuff, so, thanks, guys, for doing that stuff. And, yeah. And these GM modes, I'm gonna try to cut them down to, around 10 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes, because 20 minutes, it takes a long time to upload, because now that I have the intro with the videos, I have to, clip it up. I have to add the intro to the video, and that takes an extra amount of time to process. And so yeah, the shorter the videos are, the better. The quicker I can get the videos out. So yeah, I'll try to keep the GM modes around 10 minutes, and if that's too short, 10 minutes, I'll just put out, two 10-minute videos a day of GM mode, kind of like Hut Roulette, where I put out, two 5-minute, two 6-minute videos a day. that kind of thing. And look at that, our team is turning it around. 4-2 win and a 5-1 win. And one thing I think I talked about in the GM mode that was lost that I guess I could talk about now again was the NHL awards. In my NHL awards video, I talked about 10 awards who I thought was going to win, and I guessed 7 out of 10 of them correctly. So that was pretty cool. Patrice Bergeron is going to be on the cover for the NHL 15 game, and I mean that's all right. I mean I didn't care too much who's going to be in the cover. I mean over the past 2 years, there's been a Flyer and a Devil on the cover. So, you know, as a Rangers fan, that's pretty painful. So just to have, you know, one of those two guys on the cover, that's pretty cool. Bergeron, it was his night, pretty much. I mean, he won a lot. You know, it seemed like every few minutes they were calling him up to the podium. I mean, he won the Selke, I forget what award it is, but it's the award for, like, you know, most community service type thing. I forget what it's called. But he won that as well, and then he won the quote-unquote cover vote. So that was pretty cool. You know, he had a pretty good night for him. We'll sum it up to the end of the season here. We'll check out the stats, and then we'll see who we're facing in the playoffs if we make the playoffs. Nice 3-0 win there. And that McKinnon, I mean, that I pulled in my last pack opening video, it was crazy because when I first checked him, like, in the video, he was going for 800K, and then I think I put him up on the market, like, an hour later, and just a couple hours later, his price dropped insanely. Like, his price dropped to, like, 600K. I have him up at the time of making this video. He's up at a 590K by now, which is the cheapest on the market, and it hasn't sold yet. I think it's still got like an hour and 10 minutes left or something, so hopefully that sells. I hope to get at least 500k from him. So yeah, if you guys have any trade offers for him, you know, comment in the video or, you know, send me a message on PSN or something, because I have to sell him. I didn't even realize we're at the end here. Let's see, we've 4 games left. Zoom it up to this game right here. 37-30-11. I'm not sure if that's good enough to make the playoffs. That's 85 points. So it could be. Let's see where we're at. We have 2 games left. I don't know, why did I go to coaching? I always go to coaching when I'm trying to check the standings. Team standings. Let's see where we stand in the Western Conference. Wow, we are currently in 6th, so we're actually in a playoff spot. But we are only 2 points in a playoff spot. So we pretty much have to win the next 2 games. Pretty much have to win if we want to make the playoffs. San Jose here, they have a very similar record. Ooh, we lost 5-4. I don't know if that was an overtime loss. I think it was. So we at least got a point out of it. We got a point out of it. Now, the last game of the season against Anaheim, I'm pretty sure if we win, we have a guaranteed playoff spot. But I'm not sure. First period, nothing. Second period, oh man, we're out shooting them. Corey Perry comes through. Third period, oh, there we go, boys. The fourth liners, Cody McLeod and John Mitchell, come through. Score 2 big goals and win us the game. Man, that's huge. Alright, so I'm pretty sure we're in the playoffs. I'm going to check the player stats for the season. And then in the next video will be, of course, the first round of the playoffs. Let's see who did well in the second half of the year. I predict either Matthew Shane or Jaromir Jagr led us in points. I mean, look at Jagr right there, 34 goals. McKinnon leading us in assists on the second line. Tyson Berry, plus 26, it's pretty good. Scout assignment. We will go to the OHL, because I'm pretty sure that's where Sam Reinhardt is. Well, then, you know what? We don't really need Sam Reinhardt. Who are some good players available? Nick Ritchie, DeCall. Kuhn JHL, and a WHL. Yeah, you know what? We'll go to the OHL. There we go. Okay, now let's check out the player stats for the season. Okay, so Matt Duchene, 65 points in 82 games. I'd expect a little bit more out of the first line, but, you know, what are you going to do? Jaromir Jagr, 34 goals, 61 points. I think he did okay. He definitely guided our team into the playoff. I mean, before he came, we were not a playoff team. And then he came in and then got us back there. Alex Tanguy, what a year this guy is having. He's on our third line. And he has 57 points. How is that even possible? I don't think I've ever seen a third liner do that good. McKinnon, 57 points on and off, first and second line all year. Landeskog, 50 points in the first line. That's not good enough. 23 goals is good, but only 50 points, that's pretty good for the first line. Ooh, look at this. Tyson Barrie and Eric Johnson lit it up at the point. 43 points for Johnson, 42 for Tyson Barrie. That's great. O'Reilly, 31 points in the second line. He could be doing better. Zidlicky, 30 points. I'm not sure how much he had with us. Yakupov, only 30 points on the second line. That's not good. Talbot and Mitchell. Look at these two centers. Is Mitchell on the fourth line? Because if he has 25 points on the fourth line, that's insane. Look at the goal scoring we have. Jesus. Look at that. Wilson, 20 points. McLeod, almost 20 points. LaRose, 20 points. That's crazy. How is Varlamov doing? 2.19, 25 and, or 35 and 25. You know what, not a bad season for Varlamov. Only almost a 93 save percentage. That's pretty good. We're going to end the video there, guys. Next video, like I said, will be the first round of the playoffs. I'll see you guys there.